Welcome to Love Fellowship Believers. We're glad that you're visiting our website here today. We hope something is said that's going to bless you real good. Now we're getting ready to join us in one of our services already in progress.
25th verse. If you're writing down notes, if you have a notebook and you like to keep up with the messages that God allows you to hear, write down, stop wasting your time. And stop wasting your time doesn't identify with you, write down, playtime is over. Stop wasting your time. Playtime is over. Whichever one fits better for you. Either title is going to go with today's sermon. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. We're living in a time. We're living in a time where folk play with the Lord. Yeah, I know. It's going to be one of those. We're living in a time where folk play with the Lord. Will folk dress up on Sunday? Will folk act one way when they're in front of pastor? Will folk act some way when they're in front of someone else and play with the Lord? But this is not the season. I'm telling you, this is not the season to play with the Lord. Young folk, this is not the season to play with the Lord. The enemy wants to take away from you every single thing you have. That young lady, what was her name? Kiara that came and sung that song. Kiara, the enemy wants to take that away from you. And if you allow him to take that away from you, that's exactly what he'll do. If she allows folk to say, nah, baby, you didn't sound right, or nah, baby, you didn't do it like this, or baby, you should have did it like that, the enemy will take that away from her. Just as though he's taking some things from you. There's folk right now that have a testimony that I allowed what someone else said to take away what God was giving me. I allowed someone to tell me that, you know what, I didn't sing like everybody else sung. I didn't speak like everybody else spoke. I didn't do it like everyone else thought I should have done it, so the enemy took it away from me. Stop wasting your time. I want to read another translation of these same verses, and maybe this will resound a little better for some of us. Amen? Again, starting at the 21st verse, it says, this is the New Century Version. It says, so put out of your life every evil thing and every kind of wrong. Then in gentleness, accept God's teaching that is planted in your heart, which can save you. Now that says to put away all evil things. You don't have to raise your hand because God already knows your heart. Who hasn't put away all evil things? There's folks sitting here with titles. There's folks sitting here that have not put away all evil things. There's folk here that do wrong and enjoy doing wrong. There's folk here to say, you know what? I'm going to make time, Pastor. I'm going to make time to do wrong. To do what I know I shouldn't be doing. But I want to do it anyway. But this is not the season. This is the time to say, you know what? All that stuff, this mess. Come on, we talk on the telephone. We're living in an age where we communicate more in this time than we've ever communicated before. And we text back and forth mess. If I step on your toe, just move your foot back. These are 14s. I'll catch it again. Don't worry. texting mess, you ain't got no business texting. Sending pictures, you ain't got no business sending. Talking about mess, you don't have no business talking about. Thinking it, don't nobody else see it. My part-time job, I work on computers. And in working with computers, I was reading this article where iPhone has a new app. And it's called Tiger Talk. And what it's designed to do is for the person that's living outside of their relationship. Did you catch what I said? Uh-huh. The folk is cheating and not doing what they're supposed to do. It's designed to take their messages off the phone so they can't nobody else see their messages. Young folk, do you understand the time that you're living in? Where they would even set up stuff to allow you to do wrong. Every kind of wrong. Then in gentleness accepts God's teaching that is planted in your heart. Everyone here under the sound of my voice, if you're here today, there's a seed to be planted. But there's scripture that talks about different types of ground. It talks about different types of fertile ground. So for this seed to be planted and for it to grow the way that it should grow, we have to make sure that our ground, that our heart is in the right place. Yeah. Right now, if you sit here with malice in your heart ain't even right to receive a seed. Right now, if you're more worried about bills or worried or concerned about something else that's going on, instead of sitting right here having your heart ready for this seed, you're not right ground. Who wants to be right ground?
Amen.
Ready to receive the seed, amen? So any mess that you got going, amen? Verse 22, again, New Century Version translation. Do what God's teaching says. When you only listen and do nothing, you are fooling yourselves. How many people have actually heard the word of God tell them what it is they're supposed to do, but still go out and mess up? I'll raise my hand. Have heard the word of God. God has spoken to me and told me what to do, and then I've gone out and done the wrong thing. And then got mad. Turned around and say, well, God, why did you want to do that to me? When it was my fault in the first place. What it was is that I was playing with God. I was wasting time. Amen. But this is not the season to do that. This is the season to take every word that you hear, everything that the pastor comes with, any other leader here in this church comes and teaches and tells to you, it's not just of a coincidence that you're hearing that word. A word is being spoken for you to respond. Not for you to sit back and judge. Not for you to sit back and look at someone else. Not for you to say, you know that word was for you. No, that's time for you to take that word and say, you know what? I need to respond to this word. God allowed me to be here. This word is for me. I need to respond. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Verse 23 says, those who hear God's teaching and do nothing are like people who look at themselves in a mirror. 24 says, they see their faces and then go away quickly and forget what they look like. I was looking at a thing on TV and they were showing folk that had become celebrities. And they were talking about the first time that they heard their song on the radio or the first time they saw themselves in a movie or whatever. And they were just talking about the feeling that they had. They were saying, well, you know, wow, does that really sound like me? Or do I really look like that on TV? And it was amazing to me because God had already planted this word into me for me to share with you and to sit back and listen to that. And I said, wow. How many times have we actually been put into a situation you say, you know what, wow, do I sound like, you ever heard yourself recorded back on a CD or a tape? Amen. Maybe somebody not old enough to know about a cassette, but a CD or cassette or MP3, there you go. To hear your voice recorded back, you say, wow, do I really sound like that? Or you to see a picture that someone has taken, you say, and you know, I know a lot of times women say, well, ooh, that picture just makes me look, no, baby, that's just how you look. That's amen. Amen. But you see the picture and you say, wait a minute, do I look like that? Yeah, that's you. You don't know what you look like? That's you. Amen. But that's what it says. It says, it's like folk that look in a mirror, see their reflection in the mirror, but don't even recognize themselves. I don't know about you, but I want to recognize myself.
Amen.
I need to know who I am, so that somebody else don't come start whispering in my ear trying to tell me I'm something else. No, I want to know who I am. I want to know exactly who I am. I want to know exactly who it is God has called me to be. So that when I won't walk any old kind of way, but I'd walk the way God would have for me to walk. I won't tiptoe through the tulips, but I'll stand tall when I walk.
Amen.
Because I know who God has called me to be. And no matter what you try to make me out to be, no matter what you want to say, no matter what name you call me, no matter what title you put on me, I know God has called me to walk tall. And that's what I'm going to do. Children, we're talking about this youth thing right here, and I know that you have a lot of peer pressure. I know that there comes a time when you grow up through life, you think parents don't know. You think older folk don't know nothing. The devil is a liar. As you're growing up and you're going through life, we know that it's very important for you to have friends.
Mm-hmm.
We know that you want to be everybody's. You want everybody to be able to look at you as the person. But you know what? The truth be told, you're not going to be everybody's friend.
Amen.
There's folk that you don't want, you don't even realize it, but there's folk that you don't want to be your friend.
Oh, yeah.
There's folk that when they call out so-and-so name, you don't want your name associated with them. You don't realize that yet, but there's going to be, you don't want your name associated. So if God is allowing someone not to be your friend, count it all joy. Say, so you know what, that's all right. Because most adults sitting here right now, if they think about it, how many people have more than 5 friends still from elementary school? If you're over 25 years old and you have 5 friends from elementary school, would you stand to your feet? Young people, look around. Did you see anybody stand up? So those folk that you're dealing with elementary school that's acting all crazy and doing, that's okay. That's okay, amen?
Amen.
Amen, amen. You don't want folk telling you who you are. You want to know who you are. When you walk through life, when you walk through the school, you don't have to worry about somebody trying to define you. No, you know who you are. The young lady that was honored here for Youth Day, she won every award at the school, amen. She won. That's a wonderful thing to recognize. Where she at? She won everything at the school. And then after she won everything, she said, then I've been to school every day. So you may well be in that award too. Amen. She won everything. Now, I don't know her. I don't know nothing about her. But I would think she's not a person that walks around caring about what everybody else think about her. It sounds like she said, you know what, I know who God has called me to be, and I'm going to do what I'm supposed to do. I'm focused on doing what it is that I'm supposed to do, and I'm going to get that accomplished. Amen?
Amen.
To me, Tibia didn't seem like she was wasting time. To me, it didn't seem like when time came, she was playing around. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So here in verse 25, it says, but the truly happy people are those who carefully study God's perfect law that makes people free. Say, makes people free. That makes people free, and they continue to study it. They do not forget what they heard, but they obey what God's teaching says. Those who do this will be made happy. What I love about that translation is that it did not say would give them happiness. But it said would make them happy. There's a difference to be given happiness. A child, I can pull out this piece of candy. and I can give a child a piece of candy, guess what? They're going to be happy. But there's a difference in doing something to make a child happy, not just to give them happiness. Amen?
Amen.
My God and your God wants to make you happy. He wants you to walk through life with your head up. He wants you to walk tall. He doesn't want you to waste time. He doesn't want you to play around. He wants you to be focused on what it is God would have for you to do. If the truth be told, most of us sitting in here, myself included, I've lived more than half of my life wasting time. I've lived more than half of my life playing around. I don't want to do that anymore. This is a season right now, I believe with all my heart that this is a season right now that God is looking at his people. And he's saying, with all these distractions, with all this mess, with all this other stuff that's going on, what are you going to be true to? What are you going to commit to? You say this and you pray to me and you cry at night and you go through all these conniptions and fits and do all these different things, crying out to me, and I'm listening to you. But I know your heart. What is your heart? I hear what your mouth is saying, but what is your heart saying? You say that if I do this, you'll do that. You say that if I make a way here, then you'll do that. But last time, you asked me, I did what you said. And you didn't hold up your end of the bargain. Don't look at nobody else. Look at your heart. I saw some people do this right. Look at your heart. I'm not trying to get in your business. I don't know what you prayed for. I don't know what you did or didn't do. But you know. And God knows. The last time you prayed and you asked, did he fulfill his end? Are you doing your part? My God requires, he says, you know what? Not to forsake yourself, the assembling of one another's together. I want you to come together in a house and I want you to praise me. I want you to glorify me. I'm going to ask for a few hours on Sunday. I'm going to ask for a few hours on whatever services that are here that's going on. And I want you to be faithful to me. But how many have come up with an excuse? Who's come up with an excuse on Tuesday?
You preaching.
I tell you what if God said, you know, Pastor, what I want you to do is I want you to come up with an excuse on Tuesday. Let everybody else show up but you. Who comes up? I don't know about you, but Sunday is one of the roughest mornings to get out the house for me. Has always been. And I've just bought into it. And I said, Lord, you know what? If it's going to be rough, it's just going to be rough. And we're going to do what we do. If we 10 minutes, if we 15 minutes, then we just are what we are. But we're not stopping.
Amen.
We're not, that's another thing. We're not getting out the boat, amen. We're going to stay on the boat. We're going to keep it going. We might be late. Somebody might say something, but I know who I am, amen, and we're there. But I'd rather be late than not be there at all. And I'd rather be a little behind than not make it at all. My heart's got to be right. Amen. You sitting right here today, your heart has to be right. to receive what it is God would have for you to do. You have to be committed. You have to be committed. Amen. Somebody, I saw somebody pick up a pen. You have to have your heart right. And you have to be committed to doing what it is God has called you to do. Before you even committed, you have to understand what you're committing to. A lot of times folk have problems because they're committed to something that God didn't tell them to commit to. They're committed to an area, they're committing to a gift that God didn't give them in the first place. Just for the sake of saying they're committed. Well, I'm committed to such and such ministry, and I'm committed to such and such team, and I'm committed to do this, and I'm committed to do that. But you know what? You hurt it more than you helped it. Because that ain't where you're supposed to be. Amen. We have to know where we're supposed to be. Amen? Amen. James here was sitting here and he was writing, he was saying, look, what has to happen if we have to get rid of all of this mess in our lives? Well, why would he say that we have to get rid of all of this mess in our lives? We have to get all this rid of all this mess in our lives. We're talking about it in Bible study. You have to get rid of the mess in your life so that you can hear clearly from the Lord. If you got 1,500 other things going on in your life, it's hard, not impossible, but it's hard to hear from the Lord. Because so many other things are shouting in your life. So many other things are yelling at you in your life. But if you say, I'm putting God first in everything that I do, not in some of the things, but I'm putting Him first in everything that I do. I'm taking care of all of the mess and I'm pushing it back to the back. I'm putting God here straight in front of my face. And if I happen to see something else, it's just because it caught the corner of my eye. But I'm being concentrated on what it is God would have for me to do. Once you commit to that, then when you walk, you know what? My God isn't here. My God isn't here. But my God tells me to look up on the hill and with me looking up. It's real hard to look up and to be slumped over. It's real hard to look up and to be torn down and to be beaten up. But you know what? It makes it a whole lot easier when I look up. That I can just walk through my life. And I can say, you know what? I know God has my back. I know that this don't work out. And there was a step. But you know what? God still, He's still taking care of me. I'm just walking through it. Look at God. Look. And He comes a stumbling block. Oh, I could have failed, but He allowed me to step up. Because I'm still looking up to what it is He would have for me to do. We have to stay concentrated on the Lord. We can't get caught up with mess. Concentrate on what it is God would have for us to do. Amen. Verse 21 in the King James Version, it said, which would be able to save your soul. I don't know about you, but I want my soul to be saved. I believe right now because I've accepted Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior, I'm saved. I tell folk all the time, I don't have no plan B. It's over. It's over. If I'm wrong, I'm going to burn in hell. I don't have no plan B. But I believe I'm right. And I've taken everything that I've had and I've turned it over to Him. And in doing so, even some of the things that I wanted to do, God has allowed me to do. But I'm staying concentrated on Him. God sent me here to tell you, stop wasting your time. Stop playing around. All these other things that are going on in your life, that's not important. That's not stuff for you to hold on to. That's not something to build your foundation off of. Stop wasting your time. Stop playing around. Concentrate on the Lord. Commit to Him. Take this season right here and say, you know what, Lord, this is it. The Bible tells me that if I'm faithful over a few things, He'll make me ruler over many. commit to this. I can't play around no more. I've had enough time playing. I've had enough where I've wasted time, where I've listened to what other folk have said, where I've jumped on that telephone and I've just talked all kinds of mess and I've gossiped back and forth and I've put stuff in me that had no business being there in the first place. And now I'm wondering why I'm struggling. Now I'm wondering while I'm going through. Don't you know that seasons come so that God says, you know what, I'm going to protect you. I'm going to wrap my hand around you. I'm going to make sure you're good. I'm giving you some time to set yourself up. I'm giving you some time. I'm keeping the enemy back so that he won't mess with you. So that he won't have all kinds of stuff crazy in your life. But there's coming a time. Oh, I'm still God and I still got you. But let me see, just how well did you build up during that time? As a parent, we love our children and we want them to grow up to be strong and we protect them. And there's certain things that we keep them from. Well, why do we keep them from? Because you know what, I want you to really see what it is that's going, and we allow them to grow. But there comes a time as a parent, no matter how bad you want to hold on, no matter how bad you trying to hold on, and some folks try to put an age on it, but age ain't got nothing to do with it. If no matter how bad you try to, there comes a time where, and hopefully what it is that you've taught that child, what it is that child has learned, they're strong enough to withstand what the world is going to throw at them. Amen. And then it becomes, as a parent, all I can do is pray. That's all. Before I can fight these battles for you, baby. Before I can help you out, all I can do is pray. God does that same thing with us. He says, you know what, I love you, but I need you to put that mess away. Now's the season. Put that mess away. Don't leave here today hearing this word, allowing this seed to be dropped on you, and you don't take it. And then you look back and say, I remember I was told. Someone under the sound of my voice, this season right now, if you falter in this season right here, you're going to lose everything. I'm not one just to say something just for saying it. If you falter during this season, everything that God has allowed you to, you can lose it all. Commit to Him. James said here, there's folk that don't even know who they are. They don't even recognize themselves. Just walk past the mirror and look, and didn't even realize that was them. I ain't talking about because they look so good. But just look and didn't even recognize themselves. Can probably think back to a time that if you was to see yourself back then, wow. How would that be me? There was a time that I could look at myself like I am now and say, wow, that's not me. But recognize yourself. Know what it is God has called you to do. Stop wasting God's time. Stop playing around. Everyone in this place, stand to your feet if you're able.
Again, thank you for visiting the Love Fellowship Believers. We hope something that was said, something that was done that blessed your spirit real good. Now, if you don't know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and now you want to accept Him, would you pray this prayer with me? Father God, first and foremost, we say thank you. Thank you, Lord, for this time and this moment, for this person that has visited this website and wants to accept Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. God, I ask that you would come into their lives. I ask, Lord, that you would be the leader of their life and guide them and direct them through everything that they go through. Right now, Father God, and let them know exactly who you are and what you stand for and how you want them to live their life. Be with them forever, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. If you prayed that prayer and you want to come out and you want to fellowship with us, we meet at 3309 Burlington Road here in the wonderful city of Greensboro, North Carolina. If you're unable to find directions to there, there's places on the website that will direct you to that, even email addresses and phone numbers that will help you out as well. We love you, and so does God. Amen. Bless you.